For City Lights on Novus TV, I'm Natalie Langston. The Vancouver Home and Design Show has been a staple in consumers' calendars since 1983, attracting more than 35,000 visitors every fall. And this year is no different, with show-stopping exhibits, the latest in home and lifestyle trends, and high-profile personalities like HGTV's Brian Balmer, Colin and Justin, and Chef Corbin Tomaszewski, hosting the very first ever Celebrity Samsung Cooking Challenge you won't want to miss. Now, when it comes to achieving the chic cottage look, where do we even begin?
Oh, do you know what? If you want to think about your scheme, you've got to sit down and plan it really carefully. We always say to fail to plan is to plan to fail. And the cottage aesthetic is no different to any other. Good shopping results in good design, so know what you want. Think in terms of layers and the cozy factor. The cottage vignette and the cottage look is not about stripped back minimalism and benign kind of nothing. It's all about really indulgent, packaged, really clever looks that you put together by careful shopping.
Now, when it comes to rural cabin and urban condo settings, differentiate them for us and what brings a sense of uniqueness to each?
Okay, well, we've, as city boys, we've spent the majority of our life living in condo blocks and inner city homes and warehouse conversions, and we've tended to be fairly constructed in the interiors that we create with lots of sharp edges and square lines and 90 degree angles. Those are the things that really typify the urban aesthetic. When it comes to the cottage aesthetic, it's all about thinking about nature. And we always say we love nature in spite of what it did to us, but joking aside, it's all about creating the natural look. So lots of woody finishes and kind of like really soft edges. It's not about the sharp rectilinear design pursuit. It's much more about thinking to your and listening to your heart and shopping accordingly.
And when you suggest working with rural cabin settings as opposed to the urban condo, what do you look for?
When you're designing a cabin, it's all about connectivity. You know, it's all about actually being exposed to the wilderness and that connection. You know, on our first cabin, you know, when we did season one of Cabin Pressure, it was a log cabin. And log cabins are really cozy, beautiful timber tones, but can be quite dark by their very nature. You know, so one of the first things we did was actually blow out a couple of small windows and put three sets of double doors in so you could actually open up the space, you know, be exposed to the view, and that's your connectivity. Now, we're on season two of Cabin Pressure at the moment, and it's a much smaller, tiny little shack in the woods. But we're going for a really modern look in there. You know, we're doing drywall, this time the timber's on the ceiling. But where they've had tiny, tiny little windows, just those little sliding windows with the screen, we've actually cut the whole back wall out. Even in the smallest bedrooms, and we've put giant black framed beautiful double glazed units in so that we're connected to the forest. You know, that's the thing, there's no point driving in your car for 3 hours to sit in a tiny room. You want to be part of the action.
Now, Brian, I'm sure it's good to be back here at the Home and Design Show. Your presentation is getting the most out of your home. What do you suggest homeowners focus on first?
Well, the first thing you have to focus on is what's your budget and your plan. You've got to take time and be patient. When it comes to adding value to the home, I mean, the standards are kitchen, bathroom, basement, but it really depends how long you're going to live there. If you're planning to stay forever, do something crazy. You don't have to worry about getting that return back right away. Every 10 to 15 years, we want to renovate anyway. So if you're going to be there short term, focus on the things that buyers would want. If you're going to be there long term, do whatever you want.
In terms of renovating for homeowners, how do you suggest that they get the most out of their home renovation?
Well, I think really thinking about how you're going to use the home and how long you're going to live there, and not being careful if you're planning 5-10 years in the future, not to customize the home too much for yourself. But you really have to look at what's valuable to you and what will not only add value to your home financially, but value to the way you spend time in your home. So, you know, for me, I'm a big garage and shop guy. So, you know, heated floors in the garage, a heated driveway, maybe things like that. For me, dust extraction and air in my garage, but not everybody needs that. It's balancing the things that your home needs versus the things that you want to put in your home. That's the key.
Now, back again at the Home and Design Show as the celeb host and fourth judge in the Samsung Cooking Challenge. Tell us what we can expect during the competition.
Well, what's especially unique about this tag team challenge is that we have three amateur cooks paired with three professional chefs in the Vancouver area, which is very exciting because the twist is that we will have the opportunity to yell the word switch at any given point in time, which means the amateur and the professional don't cook at the same time, they tag team off.
Now you're tackling two different subjects. Break those down for us.
So first elimination round is the protein or the entree round. So they have to have three ingredients in there for sure, and that's bison, feta cheese, and of course, dried figs. So that has to be in their dish no matter what. And then after that round, we will judge them. Unfortunately, one is going to be eliminated, and then it goes into the final round, which is dessert. And the top two will compete to have the best dessert. And that has to incorporate apples, honey, and jalapeno peppers. Do you have a jalapeno pepper in dessert?
No.
It's going to be spicy.
Did you come up with all of this yourself?
You know, we worked together as a team to come up with some fun ideas, and hopefully it works.
And now there's more emphasis being put on children in the kitchen and educating them so that they can take what they learn in childhood and move into adulthood.
Yeah, it's really, cooking is the foundation. It's a building block in your life. And if you don't do it as a child, you know, how are you going to eat when you're older? You know, there's so many young people, especially nowadays, where, and it's amazing because we're exposed to food on so many different levels, but they don't know how to cook. So I tell parents, cook with your kids, because if you don't, you're really robbing them of childhood memories, for one. And number two, how are they going to succeed in life if they don't know how to cook and prepare food?
For more details on the Vancouver Home and Design Show, just go to their website, where you can find tips and tricks that you can use in your home today. Thanks for watching. For City Lights on Novus TV, I'm Natalie Langston.